We love the song. Anyway, we're all about the music and having fun if you haven't figured that out. And of course, your home and garden dreams coming true. Cindy Dole, Home Wizards, here every Saturday. And with me is my husband, Ben there, Bill. And so, Bill, we have just a few minutes left to go through several more key points that we need to make sure are in this contract with our next home construction contractor. Theft, right?
Yep. Theft and damage, they kind of go hand in hand. And what you need to do is make sure what the contractor's insurance is going to cover and or what your homeowner's insurance is going to cover. There's a policy called builder's risk. And it's an insurance policy, and it usually has a pretty good, you know, pretty large deductible on it. But that's something that, depending on the size of the project, you may want to consider. The contractors generally will not carry it. If you want them to, you'll be looking at an added insurance charge.
Mm. All right. Change orders. Love the change orders.
Yep.
I mean, we want granite. We decided we don't want tile.
Well, you know, there's a couple ways that change orders come from. You've just come up with, you know, a really common one where you as, you know, let's say you as the client have said, you know, instead of this, I want to go to that.
Mm-hmm.
And you know what? That happens. And what you just need to do is have a process in your agreement of how that's going to happen. The contractor is going to show you the material quote from the original vendor and the cost of the new material. And what will his markup be? What fee is he going to be allowed to put on it? If you don't spell it out, he might put 50% or 100% on the change. So you want to have that conversation, and you want to commit it to writing before you sign the contract. The other kind of change order that occurs, and it's a lot tougher to anticipate, it's one of the things you need to think about when you go into a home improvement contract, is what's called hidden conditions or concealed conditions. For example, if you're going to dig a hole, you don't know necessarily what's in that ground. You could come up with a tank, an old septic tank that would require extra cost to get rid of.
Dinosaurs.
I'm sorry?
Dinosaurs.
Yes.
Monsters.
Yeah. Or just bad soil. Soil that's very sandy needs more work than would have been expected. If you're tearing open a wall, you may find termite damage or drywall.
Oh, gosh.
You might find electrical work that was not done properly the first time. So the hidden conditions is always a dangerous part of any project because the builder doesn't know it. He's not hiding it from you. But likewise, you're both going to be facing it. And, you know, if you're going into a project and, you know, let's just say because it's a round number, it's a $100,000 project. Depending on what kind of job it is, you know, where if you're tearing open a lot of walls or if you're doing a lot of digging, you know, things that are inherently risky as far as not knowing what's there, you should be looking at anywhere from 10 to even 20% of a contingency. And it's knowing that, you know, holy cow, if I'm not careful, my $100,000 project could become 120. And then you'll know at what point, that risk is behind you. And maybe what you've done is you've taken that 20 grand and saying, you know, if the project's going well, I'm going to go with that really expensive countertop and that really expensive flooring, at the tail end of the job. But I need to make sure that I'm going to have the money to be able to pay for it. So.
And speaking of money, one of the most important things is never pay everything up in advance and maybe just a little bit up front and then, of course, save the rest when the job is completely done, like maybe a third upon signing.
I'm sorry, say that again?
A third upon signing.
A lot of contracts will say that. And,
maybe less?
I would say no way. Why would you pay somebody 30%? Of a project that hasn't even started. Now the contractor is going to say, "Well, I need to get materials," and that's fair enough.
And we're going to say, you know what, Bill? We're going to have to say we're the boss of you. Ben there, Bill. Thanks for being with us. Oh. We'll have to continue this later.
Sure.
I'll see you in a little bit. Sorry.
All right, no problem.
The great tips. We're going to put all this on the website. I mean, there's so many things to think of when you have this contract, but I hope that helped you. Some great words of advice from Ben there, Bill. You can always check it out at cindydole.com, and you can email us, too, if you're about to embark on a project and you're thinking, wow, what should I have in that contract? Hour 2 of Home Wizards. We're kicking up right now. Cindy Dole, let's get going, Seth.